17. 1880, American patriot Thomas Paine wrote these words: "These are the times, the trying souls. The summer soldier and the sunshine patriot wield in this crisis a shriek from the service of their country. But he that stands in now deserves the love and thanks of man and woman." Today we are gathered to do just that, to offer our love and thanks to the broken line of men and women who do not shriek from the service of our country. It may be possible to count the number of times America's military has been called to defend freedom throughout the world. But we will never know how many more crises have been avoided because tyrants understood that America's armed forces were prepared to defend our freedom and the freedom of others throughout the world. You can be certain, however, that there have been many such times. More than 1 million American service members died in the service of this country. More than 1.4 million lived with the wounds they suffered without fighting for us. More than 25 million former service members are still living today. They are that special group of Americans we call veterans. Today we honor them and say thank you for serving. And so as we honor all who serve, those who fought America's wars, and those who fought to keep the peace, let us remember these words from President John F. Kennedy. "Now the trumpet summons us again, not as a call to bear arms, though arms we need, not as a call to battle, though in battle we are, but a call to bear the burden of a long twilight struggle, year in and year out, rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, as struggling against the common enemies of evil, tyranny, poverty, and war itself. American veterans did not shrink from the service of their country. They do indeed deserve it.
In 1921, an American soldier, his name known but to God, was buried on the Virginia hillside overlooking the Potomac River in the city of Washington, D.C. The burial site of this unknown World War I soldier in Arlington National Cemetery symbolized dignity and reverence for all America's veterans. Similar ceremonies occurred earlier in England and France, where an unknown soldier was buried on each nation's highest place of honor. These memorial gestures all took place on November 11th, giving universal recognition to the celebrated ending of World War I hostilities at 11 a.m., November 11th, 1918. This day became known as Armistice Day. Armistice Day officially received its name in America in 1926 through a congressional resolution. It became a national holiday 12 years later by a single congressional action. But shortly after the holiday was proclaimed, World War II broke out in Europe and shattered the dream. Of the 16 million Americans who served in the armed forces during World War II, more than 400,000 died. Raymond Weeks of Birmingham, Alabama, organized the Veterans Day Parade for the city on November 11, 1947, to honor all of America's veterans for their loyal service. Later, U.S. Representative Edward H. Reese of Kansas proposed legislation changing Armistice Day to Veterans Day to honor all those who have served America in all wars. In 1954, President Eisenhower signed a bill proclaiming November 11th as Veterans Day, and called upon Americans everywhere to rededicate themselves to cause of peace. In 1968, Congress moved Veterans Day to the fourth Monday in October. However, it became apparent that the November 11th day was a matter of historic and patriotic significance to a great many Americans. As a result, Congress formally returned to the observance of Veterans Day to its traditional date in 1978.
I choose it to be, and to me that is something I admire dearly. In other countries, you can't ignore family freedom. It's important to me because I can have the best education, even if it's for free, from preschool to high school. For college, you can take loans or you can get scholarships. In conclusion, to me, freedom is I can go to any church I choose and can worship God and can be anything I want to be. And also, I can have the best education. God bless America and the many privileges come our way. Being able to have an education and choose whatever you want. One of my freedoms is I get to choose what kind of clothes I want to wear. Some schools have kids wearing uniforms, but I'm glad my school doesn't. It will be hard to wash the same uniform, so I'm glad to have that freedom. My next freedom is I have an education. I'm glad to have an education because I want to be something. I don't want to be just anybody. I want to have a job and make a lot of money. Remember his life, so that's why I'm glad to have that freedom. I'm also glad to have this freedom to choose any job I want. For example, like if I don't want to be a doctor, I don't have to be one. No one is going to make me be one. When I grow up, I can be a teacher if I want. I can choose what I want to do or pick a job that I feel free to do. In conclusion, we have many different freedoms in America. The three I talk about in my essay are my favorite freedoms. I'm also glad to be an American.
Freedom is the most important part of my life. In the past years, we people of America lost our brothers, sisters, aunts, uncles, and other relatives in our fight for just that. So many wars, so many struggles. We have the privilege to practice any religion we please, act upon any attraction to either sex, any color we please, Michael Jackson. Most importantly, capable to walk the streets of America with our heads held high. If I wish to go to school dressed in all black with cornrows down my head, I could. I would have that right. I could worship Jesus Christ, Satan, Zeus, Peter the Peacock here in America. I may not be pleased with some selected privileges that we have, but that too is another privilege and story all to itself. How many countries have been free? You don't know, or neither do I, but I doubt if it's any. Actually, I doubt if there's any besides the country that we all currently live in. I've become highly glad to have my freedom. I play a lot of all sports, especially basketball, and I wish to continue my career on the next level one day. That's another freedom that I have. See, before the 1970s, women were prohibited to play professional basketball. Now we have many professional leagues such as the NBA, WPHL, WPNFL. Many years ago, anyone with the color skin of the white was not allowed to do the same things that white people were allowed. Now they have just as many, if not more, rights than whites. They're also now allowed to hold public office, which was an unthinkable right 2 years ago. There have been many changes, both good and bad, over the course of years that have made our freedom better. That, my dear friends, is why I'm glad to be married.
Freedom to me has many different meanings, like the freedoms of liberty, justice, the ability to be able to talk to who I want, when I want, and the ability to make something of myself, if that is what I choose. Or I can become a complete bum if that is what I want. That is freedom to me. In the beginning of our country, the founders must have had a really hard time to be able to develop a plan that is still in existence today. I'm glad for this because without the Constitution, the founders of our country developed. Who is to say that our country today would be what it is now? The Constitution guarantees that our country will never be a country where the people do not have a voice to me. That is freedom. In this country, you will be whatever you want to be. To me, that is important because that means that somebody that maybe doesn't have the best life can become something that in other countries they couldn't because either they don't have the opportunities that they have in this country, or the fact that their life is already predetermined for them. In some countries, marriages are even predetermined. So even if you are in love with someone in other countries, that is too bad for you because your family is so stuck in tradition that the only thing they know is to have your marriage already figured out for you. But in this country, you can marry whoever you want. Another very important freedom to me is the freedom of religion, because once
again, this is one of the few countries where people can worship who they want and have their way. Or if a person so chooses, they don't worship at all. In all our times, most countries had just one religion, and that is one of the reasons why the pilgrims came here, because they didn't think people should be forced to practice religion how Queen or King said they should. Another great thing about living in these countries is how people can become part of other social classes than what they originally were.
Thank you. The way it all would go.
And you move the same. You know I'm hard and changed it all. And now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all went, the way it all would go.
Wilson Stoller. stand. They have the order of the Navy, the Army, the Marines, and the Air Force.
Thank you.
when a Union Army veteran, Robert L. Combs, was with his men near Harrison Landing in Virginia. The Confederate Army was on the other side of this narrow strip of land. During the night, Captain L. Combs heard a rumble of a soldier on the field. Not knowing if it was a Union or a Confederate soldier, the captain decided to risk his life and bring the stricken man back to medical attention. Crawling on his stomach through the gunfire, the captain reached the stricken soldier and began pulling him toward his encampment. When the captain finally reached his own lines, he discovered it was actually a Confederate soldier, but the soldier was dead. The captain and the leader suddenly caught his breath and an enormous shock. In the dim light, he saw the face of the soldier. It was his own son. The boy had been studying hidden in the south when the war broke out. Without telling his father, he had enlisted in the Confederate Army. The following morning, the heartbroken father asked permission from his supervisor to give his son a full military burial despite his enemy's status. His request was partially granted. The captain had asked if he could have a group of Army band members play a funeral dirge with a son at the funeral. That request was turned down since the soldier was a Confederate. Out of respect for the father, they did say they could give him only one musician. The captain chose a bugler. He asked the bugler to play a series of musical notes. He had found one piece of paper in the pocket of the abused uniform. The wish was granted. That music was a multi-human melody we now know as TAC, used at all military funerals.
A son and soldier, a married man. The time came to the hospital living in. Soon happy parents had a perfect new son. Five fingers and five toes, perfect he was, and a smile filled their faces and love filled their hearts. Time had seen it by surprise. Before they knew it, Jim was walking and talking. Troops to the playground and zoo filled the days, still proud parents had their perfect son. The day arrived, the separation was coming. Jim got on the big yellow bus, and the first day of school he did survive, as did proud parents of a perfect son. A bike he rode was straight and knees, and a home run made people cheer. Jimmy was growing and learning, so were the proud parents of a perfect son. A Chevy he drove, careful and sure, with a prom queen at his side. Jimmy was growing and learning, so were the proud parents of a perfect son. With his melon hanging along his back and a tear in his eye, the boot camp Jimmy went. Jimmy was growing and learning, so were the proud parents of a perfect son. Chris Bling had a wife, a marksman he had become. Jimmy stood a proud Marine, but sadness filled his heart. He knew one day he may have to kill, and now there were concerned parents of a grown-up son. With orders in hand, along his path, and tear in his eye, to a distant land called Vietnam he went. Jimmy is going to war now and learning how to survive with scared parents of a frightened son. Jungle heat and monsoon rains in a land called Vietnam. Jimmy arrives, belongings, beer, coat, and rifle in hand. Now Jimmy must survive. Jimmy must kill. Still, frightened parents had a terrified son. Jungle soon, light in the face, the battle had begun. Forward they moved with bullets in the air. Jimmy was surviving, with heartache killing. Still, frightened parents had their brave son. Trudging forward, dodging bullets, then suddenly, Stephen leaped in front of Jimmy, shooting, but Jimmy, still alive, held Stephen's bullet ridden with lifeless body, and unaware they still had their living son. In a letter, Jimmy tearfully, sorrowfully penned of Stephen, how he gave his life to save a frightened son. Jimmy had memories of his life and of Stephen's fate, still unaware parents had a frightened but alive son. Monsoon rains, mud, bullets in the air. Jimmy fought to get to camp 2 days until home. Then pain, blood, and a face of mud, he saw Stephen. Still, unaware parents had a dying son. A car arrived, uniformed men rang the bell. Tears filled their eyes as they heard how Jimmy died. Hands clasped the dog tags of their brave, dead son. Now, tearful, sorrowful parents await their brave, but dead son. A flag-draped coffin and gunshots and packs in the air. Tearful eyes, trembling hands outreached. Extended the flag of a perfect son to rest in Arlington now, empty her hearted parents with a brave dead son. Years later, she sat reading letters postmarked Vietnam, intensely reading about one about a man named Stephen that died trying to save her son. Tears filled her eyes now, determined parents needed to see the wall. To Washington they drove, Jimmy's letter safe in hand, At the wall they found so many names, so many boys. Letters in hand and roses, too red, too white. Determined parents searched for their perfect son. Jimmy's name they found in prayers, letters, and two roses they did leave. The closure was not quite complete. The wall they searched for another man, a letter in hand, and grateful parents searched for a great young man. To their knees they dropped when upon the shiny black wall they found the name of a brave soldier, Stephen, his name. Prayers, roses, and a letter telling of his courage they did leave, and the parents of the perfect son gave thanks and closure was complete. Uniforms in blue and hats in white, Marines approached the wall, respectfully gathering items like spying letters and roses. Two places in the wall, two roses, red and white, with letters they could find, led by parents who paid respect with tearful eyes. In a land called Vietnam, the Marines did think, two brothers did die. So with respect, they read the letters telling of a war, a boy's fighting for their country, and a parent's waiting for a son to return. A single letter at the wall brought tears to their eyes, telling of a brave young man who gave his life so a perfect son would live and return in 2 days, to parents who were so often afraid. War is ugly, and history shows it will never go away. But for a soldier and a perfect son, war will be no more, and there were still proud parents of a perfect soldier and a perfect son.
Say prayer in memory of her.
God established in my heart because of the students at Harts High School. Some of us were not going to worry much. Someone to tell you what it's like to lay in a foxhole and then see the American flag that night. It's an experience that I know these veterans stand in front of you to ever forget. And I'd like to thank the Harts High School for asking the veterans to come down here. I'd like to thank Stacy Maynard, the girl I never met, come out to preach. I know it was her job, but nevertheless, she came out to meet us. And I'd like to thank God for that. The younger generation has not forgotten where their heritage comes from. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, once again we stand in thy presence, thanking you for so much, for so many things, Father. We thank you for this nation. It was once saved. Many years ago, we have a wake of sleeping giants. Today, Father, it has been said again that a sleeping giant has been woken. We have been asleep for so many years, Father. And it has taken this to bring our nation to God. With a can opener, a knife, a box opener, or whatever it might have been, it has happened, Father, and it has brought us together. We regret those who lost their lives, Father. We regret those who are being sent on the street now to fight the terrorism, Father, as well as we are. We ask the blessing of Harts High School upon the faculty and the teachers and the students. Be with them, Father, for they have many years to come, and we hope it can come in praising your name. For these things we ask, Father, in your name, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, at this time, your work official will dismiss and go out on the lawn for Star Spangled Banner, 21 Guns and Open Tanks. Before we do that, I'd like to
first thank Nathan Bill for coming up and
Thank you. Everyone else is set. Hold still.